Sporting a notch and removing the 3.5mm headphone jack seems to be the trend among recent flagship phones. It all started with Apple removing the headphone jack from iPhone 7. And now every smartphone maker wants to get rid of the headphone jack. The funny thing is, Google even made fun of iPhone 7 for the lack of headphone jack when it launched the original Pixel 1. But only to remove the headphone jack a year later in the Pixel 2. Samsung seems to be the only smartphone maker resisting this change. But looking at how things are going, it seems like Samsung might soon join the party. Also, most likely, the upcoming OnePlus 6T will ditch the headphone jack. So what's going on? What exactly is the reason for the removal of standard 3.5mm headphone jack? Let's find out. But before we find out why smartphone makers want to kill the headphone jack, first let's look at how the jack actually works. The headphone jack has three purposes: get stereo audio out of the phone, get mono audio into the phone, and to get volume and pause or play signals into the phone. The most commonly used headphone jacks in phones are the TRS jack and the TRRS jack. The TRS type jack supports stereo sound, but it doesn't support microphone. So you can only listen to music, but you cannot make calls with this type of headphones. There is also a different variant of TRS jack which supports mono audio and microphone. As many of you think, headphones and headsets are not the same. A headset is actually the combination of a headphone with a microphone. Most modern smartphones use the TRRS plug which supports both stereo audio and microphone. But there are, however, two different pin alignments, namely OMTP and CDIA, depending on where the mic and the ground are placed. The OMTP headsets are mainly used in older Nokia, Samsung and Sony phones, OnePlus One, and almost all phones sold in China since 2009. The CDIA headsets are used by iPhones and almost all new Android phones. So, no matter what phone you have, your manufacturer would have followed either OMTP or CDIA standard. The problem is, they are not interchangeable. This is probably the reason why your friend's headset didn't work on your smartphone. Now that we have understood how the headphone jack works, let's find out why companies want to get rid of the headphone jack so badly. The reason is, the headphone jacks are actually pretty big and occupies a significant amount of internal space within the smartphone. And not just the jack itself, there is also the audio amplifier and digital to analog converter circuitry to consider. So there is hardly any space for any new components inside the smartphone. And with the recent trend towards thinner and sleeker phones, the headphone jack just doesn't fit inside the smartphone. Also, removing the headphone jack could potentially make room for bigger batteries, bigger camera modules like the Face ID in iPhones, and it also makes waterproofing phone much easier. This makes sense, but since smartphone makers are moving away from the headphone jack, what option do we have to listen to music? In case of iPhones, you can use the headphone jack that come with Apple's Lightning connector, or if you still prefer your existing wired headphones, you can buy Apple's Lightning to 3.5mm headphone jack dongle. In case of Android, you can either use USB Type-C headphones or you can buy USB Type-C to 3.5mm connector dongle if you still prefer to use your existing headphone. The third option is to go completely wireless and use Bluetooth headphones. As Apple has demonstrated with the success of AirPods, that if you provide a compelling wireless alternative with a sleek design and convenient pairing system, people are ready to make the change. And since our future is wireless, Bluetooth headphones seems to be the next logical step into the future. So by all means, removing the headphone jack might look like a rational decision. But here are the problems. Your current pair of headphones will be useless without the headphone jack. It requires special dongles, and dongles cost money, and they can easily get lost or broken. Both of which are problems that didn't exist before. Also, you can't listen to music while charging your phone, since both use the same port. And again, to do so, you need a separate dongle just for this. And if you only have Lightning or Type-C headphones, you can't plug into your laptops or PC, which still uses 3.5mm jack. That's one more additional dongle.
Can I still use these headphones with the 10? Yeah, but you'll need an adapter, or as most people like to call it, a dongle.
A what?
A dongle.
A dongle?
Yeah, a dongle. It comes in the box.
But what if I just need to charge at the same time?
Then you're gonna need another type of dongle.
Like a double dongle?
Yeah, like a double dongle, I guess.
That sounds explicit.
But hey, you might even argue that you can use Bluetooth headphones. The problem here is, Bluetooth headphones usually don't last long before running out of charge. And besides Apple's AirPods, there aren't many good Bluetooth headsets in the market. Further, iPhones and Android use different headphone connectors, making it impossible to use headphones made for iPhones to be used with Android phones and vice versa. So essentially, locking you further into one ecosystem. But the fact is, headphone jacks work just fine and they're extremely useful. But at the end of the day, it all comes down whether you agree that the improvements gained overweigh the usefulness of the 3.5mm headphone jack. So, what do you think about the recent trend towards the removal of the headphone jack? Let us know in the comment section below.